In this video lecture, we're going to focus on solar radiation. And when we talk about solar radiation, we'll start with the basics and talk about the three basic pathways of energy. The three pathways of energy are conduction, convection, and advection. Now, conduction is a linear movement of energy. The convection is a vertical movement of energy. And advection is a horizontal movement of energy. This, the conduction, is relatively simple. And so what happens is you get molecules that are right next to each other. These are molecules and they're right next to each other. And we'll say these are molecules within a rod, an iron rod. And so you may be able to figure out where I'm going with this. If we apply heat to a molecule, and then you increase the heat of that molecule, it wants to vibrate, and it will vibrate. When you apply heat, molecules move faster. So it begins to vibrate, and then it runs into the next molecule and then hits the next, and it's a domino effect where the whole rod begins to vibrate. All these molecules begin to vibrate. And so what happens is you start getting these molecules moving very fast and the iron rod begins to glow red. And then it just starts to move in this direction toward your hand if you're holding it. So molecule begins to vibrate, it hits the next one, hits the next one, hits the next one, hits the next one, until they're all vibrating and producing heat. Okay? So that is conduction. This is conduction, a linear movement of energy. The next one is that vertical movement of energy. If you take, for example, a source of heat, okay, we have our flame here, and then we increase the heat, we have air or a fluid that begins to rise because it's warm. It rises, and then eventually it starts to cool off and descend, all right, and sink because it's now cold, and then it gets taken back up by the heat, the source of heat. So we have warm, cold, warm, cold, warm, cold. And I'm going to go ahead and complete this over here. We have sink because it's cold, and then it gets taken up. So we get this situation where you've got warm, rise, cool off, sink, cold, and starts the whole process again. So we get this situation. We get warm, rise, cold, sink. Warm, rise, cold, sink. And so this is a change in density, if you will. The reason why the water or the air rises because it's becoming less dense. Less dense, more dense, because it's now cold on the outsides here. So we get warm, rise, less dense, and then it sinks because it's cooling and it's becoming more dense. So we get rise, sink, rise, sink. This is convection. Convection. And the one thing that you probably recognize from this pathway of energy is a pot of boiling water. You apply the heat, okay, you've got the heat down here, and you begin to rise, the water begins to rise and bubble, it then cools off, and then it comes right back down and starts the whole process again. So a convection is exactly like a boiling pot of water. All right. In the atmosphere, convection is basically your popcorn thunderstorms. That's how thunderstorms build. A cloud builds from convection. Okay. So that is convection, the vertical movement of energy. On the other side of this, the last point of the pathway of energy is advection. Advection is a little more difficult to kind of grasp. So let me give you some analogies here. You fill up a bathtub. Okay, here's the faucet. You fill up a bathtub with water, okay? Put our feet here. There's an old bathtub. And so what happens, it starts out cold. So you got mostly cold water down here, okay? And eventually out comes warm water. Now, if you think about it, the warm water is now beginning to collect here. What about over here? Over here, you still got the cold water. It is extremely cold. And you step in, okay, you step into it, and it's still cold. Eventually, it begins to warm over time. And then it becomes all warm. That is simply what advection is. You know, if we drop, another example would be to take food coloring, red food coloring, dye, and squeeze it into this now full bathtub. What you see first are streams and little ribbons of that food coloring in the water. Over time, it advects, and so it disperses, and then instead of having just isolated ribbons, you now have the entire water looking pink. Okay, that's advection. It started out as ribbons of red, and then over time they begin to spread out, advect. When we talk about advection in the atmosphere, we refer to the cold front that moves in. There's cold air behind here, and as it moves, it advects. It advects into warm air. All right, and same with a warm front. If we have a warm front that moves in this into to the northeast, we're talking about the warm air is advecting into cool air. Okay, it moves. It really advects. It's not necessarily moving. It's just changing the quality, changing the property of that air. So again, we have three pathways of energy. The first one is a linear pathway, which is conduction. And then we have the convection, which is vertical, and the advection, which is horizontal. All right, now, measuring radiation is the next part of this. There are three ways to measure radiation and to measure this energy. Okay, the first one is by wavelength. We measure the wavelength, and here's a wave, it's radiation. We measure the wavelength by either doing one of two things. One is measuring the distance from the crest to crest, or measuring the distance between the trough to another trough. That is measuring wavelength. Okay. So if we take this, these two examples, wavelength, A and B, which one is going to be a short wave, A or B? The answer is B, because the distance between these two crests is shorter than those two crests. This is a long wave, this is a short wave. Again, measuring wavelength, we measure the distance between the crest to the crest or the trough to the trough. And a short wave will have the crests or the troughs very close into each other, and a long wave, the crests will be farther apart, okay? With this, with just wavelength, which one of these is going to be more powerful? The answer is B, because you have more crests and more troughs that are pushing through. So the B is going to be stronger. A short wave is stronger wave. Long wave is less powerful. The second way to measure a wave or the energy or radiation is by its amplitude. Amplitude is taking this wave and from its midline, you are measuring the distance of the crest to that midline. Or the midline, the distance from the midline to the trough. And that gives us amplitude. So again, The amplitude is the distance between the midline to the crest or the midline to the trough. That is amplitude. And so let's bring in two examples and find out which one has a greater amplitude. Here's A, and here's B. Which one has the greater amplitude? The answer is A. A has the greater amplitude because if we draw the midline in, here's the distance between the midline and the crest versus this. This one's a little more, there's the midline, and then this one has a very short amplitude. Okay? So this has the greater amplitude while this has a very soft or very gradual amplitude, a very small amplitude. Okay? Stronger, weaker. Stronger, weaker. A is stronger because it's got a greater amplitude. All right. The third and final way that we can measure waves or energy or radiation is by its frequency. And frequency is taking a wave and counting the number of times this crest or trough passes a given point in time. So we have, here's the point, okay, and how many times does a wave, or a crest, I should say, how many times does a crest pass this point in time? That is frequency. For example, let's bring our two examples back in, A and B. A and B. Which one has a lower frequency number, A or B? The answer is B, because you have, if this was all one time, if we said this is 1 second, if we said 1 second, there would be this number of waves in 1 second. We are crests, 1, 2, and 3. So we've got three. We've got three crests. And this, in 1 second, this is a short wave, went 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Nine crests that pass a given point in time. So this has a lower frequency than this. Now I'm going to bring in some music. Music, if you have at the other end, the bass portion of the piano, down here at the very end, if you're watching me and I've got a piano and you play this side, this would be a low frequency. If I play up here at the upper register, the high end of the piano, then we've got a higher frequency. So higher tones have higher frequency. Lower tones have lower frequencies. Now, we've talked about the pathways of energy. We've talked about how to measure radiation. Now, how does this all play out? There is a spectrum that is called the electromagnetic spectrum, where we have taken all of this, all of these different types of radiation, and put them or classify them and put them in order according to their wavelength. So if we start out here, we have short wave, which is very powerful. And then we end up with long wave. Okay, if we look at this is a midline. We have extremely short wave, and then over time they get larger and larger, longer and longer, longer. And I didn't quite do that right. Here we go. Let's do there. There we go. That's much better. All right. So we get short wave, and then we get longer waves. The most powerful of the short wave are the gamma rays. And then we get into the next long wave of the short wave, and that is the X-ray. And then of the short wave, the longest wave of short wave is going to be your ultraviolet, your UV radiation. And then we get into the colors, which is the visible portion of the spectrum that you see. This is the point that we see. If we have ultraviolet here, the next in the colors is going to be violet. And then we go through the colors, and then we end up with red. We end up with red. Now we're going into the long wave portion of the electromagnetic spectrum, and we begin with this portion of the EMS. We begin with the infrared. The infrared. And then we get into the longer of the long wave, and that is microwave. We deal with this, microwaves. And then finally we end up with radio waves. And the radio waves we listen to, FM, AM, those are long waves. So again, we start with the short wave, very powerful. Very powerful radiation, gamma rays, then we go to X-rays, and then UV. We begin our visible with the violet through the colors, end up with red, that ends the visible portion of the electromagnetic spectrum. We get into the long wave portion, which is the infrared, which you feel. You can sense. If somebody is sitting next to you, you feel their heat. That is infrared, okay? That is infrared. Then we go into the longer, the next longer wave, and that is microwave. And then the last long wave is the radio waves. We go from gamma rays all the way to radio waves. And this is the electromagnetic spectrum that is based on wavelength.